One of the other tunes you sang at that Hong Kong King show was a tune called Hypocritical World, and this was so unfunny. Like, tell us about that.
Oh, hypocrite. Well, as a social commentary, yes. Well, that's the kind of world we're living in, a hypocritical world. And I just see it fit to make a song. That was for the Hong Kong King, because we had to do a new song. And, well, I have a lot of serious ideas, you know, in my mind. And, you know, when that competition came up and I realized I had to do a new song, I just decided to work on that one hypocritically. Well, you know, that song is just about the hypocrites, you know, in the world.
In this corrupt world, everybody wants control. And those who's at the top, it's they who have the place. So corrupt, others say they care, because they want to get up there. And whenever they get through, the corruption just continues. Hypocrites in the government,
hypocrites
in the House of Parliament,
hypocrites
them politicians,
hypocrites,
yes, ruling the nation, hypocrites.
There was a NJAC sponsored show. I think it was a night of fun and laughter. And it's the first time I ever heard you sing a song composed by someone else. A song called Sponsorship, written by Dacron. What prompted that?
Well, they asked me to do that. They gave me a tape to learn the song. Mm-hmm. And I did it, you know. I think most of the singers were singing somebody else's song. Yes, you know, and they wanted me to do that one, and I did it.
Last week when I met Lord Funny, my friends, well, is he who tell me that the university recommends sponsors for we. I say, Funny, that's a good thing. No longer will we be scrunting. He say, happiness at hand, suitable sponsors for every Calypsonian. And then he tell me, Fernandez go be sponsor in Terra, and Castura go take your pretender. The zoo go to sponsor the Brigo. They want Burroughs to sponsor Valentino. Quattro Center and Sagom's done offer sponsorship for Lord Blakey and the Prowler. The Mighty Shadow, he go be them all. He go be sponsored by the St. Anne's Hospital.
Let's go to 1987 and the 25th anniversary of our independence, when I would say it was another high point in your career, when you made a big impact on the public with this tune, How You Feel. Let's talk about How You Feel.
Yeah, well, this competition was coming up. I heard about it, and I thought about the idea hit me, you know, How You Feel. You know, they had you know, everybody had to sing their, what do you call it?
The independence.
A theme. Yes, they had a theme that they had to do. And I thought about, you know, How You Feel, because How You Feel is something always in your mind, you know, about the independence. So it wasn't, I didn't have to look hard to find out how I feel. And, but the funny thing about it is, just that word, How You Feel, it gave me a lot of trouble to find that word. I know what I wanted to do, but the word, How You Feel, it took me a lot. And as a matter of fact, the song started from the second verse. I never made the first verse. Because the way I wanted to introduce the song, I was getting a lot of trouble in introducing the song. I decided, look, let me go to the second verse and then come back. And I was getting so much trouble to introduce the song that the song ended up starting there in the second verse.
Trinidadians and Tobagonians,
This land belongs to every man. And since we got independence, it means hard work for you and me. Independence means unity. It means you gotta fight. It means we need cooperation. Fight with all your might. It means if you have to work, work your fingers to the bone. It means that you're on your own. 25 years after, how you feel? You feel you put your shoulders to the wheel. You feel you post by and achieve. You feel you clean up the mess. You feel you could stand up proud and say, you feel that you did your best. You feel that we just keep moving on. Oh, back in back on we heal. 25 years after, how you feel? Tell you.
It went well.
Very well indeed. In fact, you won the prize for the best composed calypso on independence. Mm. So it must have been a disappointment that you didn't win the overall competition.
Well,
second tune, them confounded children. What happened, do you think?
Well, they probably didn't like humor. I think, you know, they was expecting something else. You know, I decided to do confounditure, and a lot of people liked it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of people call me after, and they like the song, particularly the women. Yeah, they like confounditure. A lot of people say they like the song, confounditure. And I just choose to do that because I wanted to do something more humorous, you know, on a different side.
Them confounded children living next to me. Well, they have their whole life in well misery. It's about 15 of them, both girls and boys. They would ram, they would sway, they would jump, they would play man his whole night, and they look at you and get away noise.
Mommy,
John, take me pillow.
Mommy,
Johnny, mash me too.
Mommy,
even in my place.
Mommy,
Fred making monkey face.
Mommy,
Patrick pity bed.
Mommy,
burn coffee in my head.
Mommy,
I want some water to drink.
Mommy,
Daphne mouth smelling stink. Yes, I tell you.
If I had to select a tune that probably had the most depth in it, other than How You Feel, it would be Time Flies. And, you know, it can even recite like poetry, and I would like you to go through the chorus of that for me.
Oh, yeah. The day before yesterday was yesterday, yesterday. Yesterday was today, yesterday. Today was tomorrow, yesterday. Tomorrow, today gonna be yesterday. Day after tomorrow, tomorrow gonna be yesterday.
While walking in the city, I met an old girl friend. We grew up from small. She was surprised to see how much that I got. And so handsome and tall. She said, it doesn't seem like long, we were so very young. You mean so much, time went by. Like was just the other day, we used to run and play. Oh, how time could really fly. So I show up, the before yesterday. Was yesterday, yesterday. Yesterday was today. Today was tomorrow, yesterday. Tomorrow, today will be yesterday. Day after tomorrow, tomorrow will be yesterday.
Another good song, just about a couple of years ago, that you wrote, Certain Things Remind Me of Certain Things.
Yeah. I think I got that idea from I think Rio prompted that idea to me. And most time when a person give me an idea, sometimes it takes me 2 or 3 years before I actually work on it. Yeah? But you know, when it really hit me and I decided to do it, yeah, certain things remind me of certain things. And that's how it came about. I just, you know, simple. Certain things remind me of certain things and I just work on it.
People always asking me why I sing certain things. What does be going through your head? Where you does be thinking? Boy, them calypsos is really something. How you think about them thing to sing? All I could say, friends, don't take nothing. You see, certain things does remind me of certain things. The Tesoro scandal and John O'Halloran does remind me of Eric Williams. When I remember Eric dead and gone forever, but then I don't remember is he was PNM. The other day I see a white person in the lap of a blonde lady, and I remember my partner Georgie. Certain things remind me of certain things. That is why I always sing certain things. Yes, I tell you.
Sometimes do you find yourself getting a mental block, nothing coming?
Yes, it happens. Yeah, that happens. And most times my ideas either come early, very late, in between there, like in the middle of the year, I'm just struggling.
Did that cause you to sing a calypso called What to Sing?
Right. Yeah, but that came down very well. That is what happened. You know, I didn't know what to sing, and that is where the idea came.
What to sing when you don't know what to sing? It's really nerve-wracking. Look at you, how you sit on listening. To hear how I come in. All my fans, them asking me what I come in with. Everybody want to hear a little piece of me hit. But I have nothing to sing, and you know I wouldn't lie. So every night I'm coming back to tell you why. I wanted was to sing about the ministry I held, how it is a failure. Wassa is a waste, see and take is boo. Hemp is disaster area. Or sing over our old song, like Sparrow, Kokoma that mash the place down. So I decide to sing over Farmer Brown and the Jackass and John. But his chalky tell me sing about the Jackass alone. He says sing about Robinson. Yes, I tell you.
What stands out in your career?
Well, a lot of things. The independence competition, the song. After that competition, my phone rang for 2 days. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 2 days straight, and my mother couldn't get me. So every time she ring, the phone was busy. People ring all day. I remember even from New York. 4 o'clock anymore. When I stepped in this house, and that's when the phone was ringing, mm-hmm. and I couldn't sleep.
25 years have gone, how you feel? You feel we have things covered and well sealed. You feel that them leaders paved the way. You feel that we produce champs. You feel where honesty was a must, or you feel was a set of scams. You feel things looking shaky to fall, or we standing solid like steel. 25 years have gone, how you feel?